I'm a beer brewer for about a half of my life. I have a friend, a microbiologist. He sat and drank beer at a bar for one night, and then we had this crazy idea to try to revive cells from the pottery that you can find in the sites around Israel.
We are sitting here now at Ramat Rachel, a site of a palace from the 7th century until the 3rd century BCE. It's the most prominent building in Judah. We came down on a trash pit of dozens of store jars, and these store jars had on them the stamp impression saying Yahud, Yud Hey Dalet, which is the name of the province.
Over the last 20 years, we have been excavating at Tel Safed, particularly from the destruction of the site mentioned in the biblical text when Hazael, the king of Aram Damascus, destroyed Philistine God around 830 BCE. You can see it's a large jug, and it has a strainer at the bottom of the spout. Archaeologists call this a beer jug.
Beer was very basic commodity in the ancient world. It was consumed by rich, poor, little children, even infants, to elder people.
When we managed to take a sample from within and revitalize the spores of yeast and recreate beer, this was astounding from all perspectives.
We tried to isolate the yeast by growing them, by getting rid of the bacteria. And surprisingly, very surprisingly, we succeed.
Up to 5,000 years, these cells of yeast were able to sit there and wait for the conditions to change. We managed to revive them, and we managed to decode their genome.
The most surprising thing for me is that yeast can survive so long in a pot, without food, without energy. It really strengthens my opinion that life and microorganisms are strong, they can live forever. And here we actually show that.
I hope that people will one day have the opportunity to experience what we experienced here with these strains and these flavors and recipes that we're trying to recreate from old times.
Most fascinating thing was that we could taste the beer that ancient people like the Palestinians or Judean used to drink.
It's like a time travel where you travel back to the past and you actually drink what the ancients drink. And this is something that you can't describe if you don't taste it yourself.
The thought that you can actually drink something that was produced something like 2,500 years ago, it's unbelievable.
It's an excellent example of how the archaeological finds can be used to explain the past, to understand the past, to understand the cultures of the past, but also to connect the public to its history, its past, its culture, and eventually, hopefully, they'll be able to drink beer coming from 3,000 years ago, 5,000 years ago, and it's something that I think everybody will enjoy.
Hi. 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 Hi.